guys, welcome to today's episode on Farm with Mildred. And for today, I'm going to show you how we're going to do picking of managu. And as I always tell you, there's a beauty in agriculture, and in agriculture, there's wealth. Managu is a Kenyan vegetable that is normally used here in Kenya, and so many people feed from it and they love it. So many people love it because it aina ile ukali, ni kitu too soft. Ni managu iko soft, ni chakula ambayo iko soft. Vegetables ambazo ziko soft tunaziita mboga za kienyeji. In my small farm I have just like 10 lines, and in these 10 lines I'm going to show you how we do picking. So many people think that it's easy, but it's not easy. There's a way of picking it so that it can sprout out next time, so that it has to take us 7 days from the first day of picking. So another 7 days you're going to pick some managu from your farm, and for you to pick and it can sprout very well or very nice and in a very good manner as it's supposed to be, you need to do some follow-ups, or you need to do some necessary things here in the farm. As I'm going to show you how I'm going to pick it. So many people may think that 10 lines is just small managos, it cannot feed some 2 to 3 people, but I want to promise you that after this episode, I'll show you this managu itakuwa mingi, ambayo itaweza kusaidia watu kama 10 kukula, kushiba from this managu. Follow me as I show you how I'm going to do this picking, and to follow this and many more episodes, don't miss to watch, subscribe and follow in my YouTube channel on Farm with Mildred, or my Facebook account Farm with Mildred, so that I can show you more and I can teach you more about doing farming in this small farm. For youth, don't worry, a small piece of land can help you get some more things, or maybe you can do some more farming. There's so many types of farming that you can engage yourself into. As for myself, I engage myself into managu farming, and this is what I'm going to do right now. Don't miss to follow me. Hivi ndo tunachuma. Ukiangalia sasa, unatoa hivi. This is another type of managu, but haijakoma ama haijafika kiwango ambayo inachumwa. Here I have two types of managu. I have these ones and these ones. The ones that I've picked, I'm picking these ones. This one is naita managu ya kienyeji. And this one is hii si managu ya kienyeji. Huwa iko na jina lake, but si managu ya kienyeji. Ni managu ambayo imekuja sasa hivi, lakini si kali. Kuna wale ambao wanadhani hii type of managu ni kali, but si kali kwa wale ambao hawajatumia. But for now, hii haijakomaa ya kutolewa matawi. So we are going to pick this one. Tukianza kutoanisha, natoa hivi. Na natumai unaona vile ambavyo tunatoa hivi. Ilipokuwa imemea ilikuwa imejaa, lakini ukitoa inabaki kidogo. So next time when you come utapata tena imejaa huku kwote. As you can see, I'm already picking. You have to pick this managu keenly. You have seen? You have to pick everything so that for those ones that has already sprout out, you have to pick them keenly so that you leave a small one, like some leaves, 2 to 3 leaves, so that it can help in sprouting out next time. As you can see, this is already 2 lines. I'm in the 3rd line, but ukiangalia, my basin is almost full. As you can see, this is how we do it. As you can see, if you get unwanted weeds from the farm, you just have to remove it so that they cannot compete for nutrients with the managu. So as you can see, this is how we do it. In a managu farm, in my small farm, we have these are weeds. So weeds, nikiendelea kuchuma managu yangu, wanaendelea kutoa weeds. Hizi weeds zinazitoa so that next time is going to compete. So mimi nafanya hivi. And for this managu, hii managu ndio the second time na chuma, but as you can see, they're still okay. Kuna wale ambao wanasema eti you cannot harvest managu like 3 times, but you can do that in fact up to 7 times. It only depends on how you harvest your managu from the farm and what criteria do you follow. When you harvest, make sure unatoa kila kitu, like hizi vijiti zote. Unachuna hivi yote kabisa. As you can see, inaonekana kubwa, but when I'm going to make it for eating, utatoa hii, utatupa the unwanted sticks from the managu veggies. So ni vizuri uchure kutoka shambani vizuri, uende kutengenezea huko kwa nyumba, so that unapea hizi time ya hii managu kumea vizuri when you are doing your farming or when you are doing this for business. As for me, for this time round, I'm not doing it for business. Hii ndio nafanya ya for just for demos and to use. It's for kutumia hapa nyumbani, si ya kuuza. But ikikuwa mingi still, I can sell. So for many, for this and many more episodes, don't miss out to watch, subscribe, and also like. Leave your comment there if you need to get some more classes on how to do managu farming, especially if you are a youth, especially when you are young, you don't know how to follow or how to do this. You can follow me so that I can be teaching you how to do this type of farming. Till next time, the same time and same date. Bye-bye.